Hi everyone, it's Jody, back here with Strength and Wisdom Tarot, here to do a random reading for October 2nd. The mind that they are random. So take your applies and leave the rest. Thank you for everyone who has liked, subscribed, and shared to my channel. Love you guys, you rock. And if anyone would like a personal reading with me, all the info will be in the box below. So let's see what's shaking for August 2nd. First card that wanted to come out is the Four of Wands. And this is the marriage card, or taking something to a higher level, a deeper commitment. Wow. We've got the Ace of Swords. Truth, clarity, along with a brand new love. Awesome. Followed by the Devil. Followed by the Ten of Swords. The feeling backstabbed, the feeling betrayed. Folks, this kind of looks like to me of a renewed love. A love that has more faith and more hope in it, perhaps. We have the Two of Swords. Right under the Four of Wands. Indecisiveness. Turning a blind eye, maybe. Maybe this person doesn't know the truth. Whoa. The Star card. Right under the Ace of Swords. A wish being fulfilled. Whoa. We have the King of Swords. Your Gemini, your Libra, your Aquarius. Right under the Ace of Cups. Get the Fool. The beginning of the beginning. And that's right under the Devil. Interesting spread. Oh, that's too many. Oh, one flipped over. And then we have the Hermit. The Hermit right under the Ten of Swords. And at the bottom of the deck, we have the Five of Cups. And the Five of Cups is mourning the loss. I call it the All Hope is Not Lost card. This man's on his knees, devastated by the loss of three cups. If he just turned around, he still has two cups left. If it's the card, you know, of the Two of Cups, that's that soulmate connection. The I get you card. So let's see how this plays here. So we have something going to the next level. A commitment. Possible marriage. And a truth has been known. The universe has given somebody truth. Clarity. The universe has also given this person a brand new love. Then you have the Devil. And the Devil could be passion, desires, obsessions or illusions, you know, of course. But with the Ace of Swords here, I think it's cutting right through the BS and getting to the heart of a matter. And the matter is a brand new love. Especially if somebody feels backstabbed and betrayed. Lied to, cheated on, what have you. And this is at the end of the cycle. You know how I feel about this card, folks. I am so done with you. Deuces. I think somebody has either gotten another shot at love and is truth and clarity now from this. Because the second row we have, the being indecisive, turning a blind eye, but the Moon is here as well. And this is maybe not knowing, the truth of a situation in a matter. But I think the truth is coming out in a huge way. A big, brilliant way. Because after that, we have the star. And the star is a healing energy. And whether you pray or you speak to the universe when you're alone, universe hears you. Your spirit guides, they hear you as well, and they're with you. It's a wish being granted. And that being right under the Ace of Swords, it is a truth and a clarity, okay, of a healing, of a situation that can be healed. The truth, I think, here in the matter is somebody knowing the truth, and that is what brings them a brand new love, possibly with this King of Swords person. Like I said, Gemini, Aquarius, Libra, or somebody who takes on these properties. This is somebody who does not wear their heart on their sleeve. They mean what they say what they mean. They're very analytical. It's always, you know, of the mind and not of the heart. But this time, being under the Ace of Cups, maybe the truth is this person seeing the truth. Because we have the biggest air element of all here, the Ace of Swords. Somebody sees the truth about how they really feel. They're not neglecting it. They're not pushing it aside. They're not analytically trying to pick it apart anymore. What it is what it is. And it seems to me it's like true, pure love. And maybe somebody here has gotten the wrong message. Or something came out wrong. Perceived wrong. Because right after that, we got the Fool. The beginning of the beginning. And again, Aces of Swords and Ace of Cups. Brand new love. Brand new truth and clarity in the matter. That puts perhaps a couple on a different path and a different road. One that's more carefree. Taking that risk. Taking a chance. Perhaps taking a chance in love. And then after that, you have the Hermit. Now he follows his intuition. He's a seeker of knowledge. He doesn't rely on everybody else to find out what he needs to find out. He gets his info on his own. That way he knows it to be true. And that's right under the Ten of Swords. So let's break this down, folks. Someone here does not have all the info about taking a commitment to a higher level or deepening a bond. But the truth comes in. It seems to me somebody was wishing for the truth, wanting the truth from somebody. And it hits them. It hits that person. Can't explain this one away. You feel what you feel, and maybe somebody finally get out of their head, back into their heart. And by expressing those desires, those passions, it sets them free. Free from a situation that might have seemed hopeless. But internally, this person knows that they have true love. So, wow. Folks, wow. I like it. So that's what I have for you. Please keep on liking, subscribing, and sharing to my channel. And I will see everybody back here real soon. Take care.